Hello, Lakers Nation. The NBA trade deadline is almost here. We are now less than 24 hours away from the deadline. And according to a number of rumors, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope is the Laker that is most available out there on the market. But what does KCP think? We're going to get into that today. I'm Trevor Lane for LakersNation.com. Subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. And don't forget to ring that notification bell right over there. All right, so we've heard from multiple different people that KCP is the name the Lakers are most interested in trading here at the deadline. And part of that is not just that he's been struggling shooting, but it's also his contract. He's got a deal that runs for a few more years. And if you are able to part with that and free up some long-term salary, it might make it a little bit easier to retain guys like Dennis Schroeder, Alex Caruso, and Talen Horton-Tucker, with those first two guys set to be free agents and Talen Horton-Tucker set to be a restricted free agent this offseason. So there's certainly a financial component to potentially moving KCP as well. However, what we are hearing right now is that the Lakers are unwilling to attach anything to KCP, and that is according to Brian Windhorst of ESPN. They don't want to add any type of a draft pick or a young player like, say, Talen Horton-Tucker to KCP in order to move them, which might indeed limit their options in terms of getting a deal done. But after the loss to the Pelicans last night, KCP was asked about the rumors, and here's what he said, and I think he handles it probably the best way that you can. "I'm just here to do my job. If I'm in trade rumors, that's something I don't really have control of. So I only really think about what I can control, and I come out here and do my job." When asked about whether or not there was any uncertainty in the locker room because of the trade deadline combined with LeBron and Anthony Davis's injuries, KCP said, "Maybe. I don't know. I don't know who is all in the trade talks. I haven't really paid attention to it. It's my first time hearing about it." All right, so is it really KCP's first time hearing about any of these trade talks? Probably not, but this is the best way to handle this. And we've seen in the past where Lakers teams have been distracted at the trade deadline because of rumors and things of that nature. Maybe that's part of the reason why they did not look good last night against the New Orleans Pelicans, but KCP is at least saying all the right things here, because as difficult as it can be for all of us, really, to sometimes accept that some things are simply outside of our control and are going to happen regardless of what we do, for an NBA player at the trade deadline, they have to do their very best to block out all of the noise and find ways to still get on the floor and produce. Now, of course, KCP did not play well at all against the New Orleans Pelicans, but he is saying this is not a factor. This is not something that's bothering him. And at 28 years old, KCP is a veteran, been around for a while, been through multiple trade deadlines before. However, this isn't like last year when he had a de facto no trade clause. This year, he does not have that protection. And I do think that if the Lakers make a move, it's probably going to be KCP at just over $12 million this season. That's a very easy contract to trade if you're going to try to get back something of value. You look at a guy like, say, Talen Horton-Tucker at just $1.5 million. That's simply not enough money going out to get anything significant in return for him. So Kentavious Caldwell-Pope makes a lot of sense financially, as well as in terms of what other teams are looking for as a 3-and-D style player. Now, of course, we know KCP hasn't been shooting very well recently, but there is still hope that he can turn things around. We all know how streaky he can be. For the Lakers, of course, if they hang on to him, the hope is going to be that he does turn things around sooner rather than later and get things going, because he started off the season red hot, looked like one of the best shooters in the NBA, and the hope is that come playoff time, he can rediscover that level of play. But give me your thoughts. Should the Lakers move Kentavious Caldwell-Pope at the trade deadline? And if you do move him, what is it that you're looking for in return? Give me your thoughts in the comments down below. And don't forget, if you guys want to follow me on social media, you can find me at @Trevor_Lane on Twitter, @TrevorLaneNBA on Instagram and Facebook. Till next time, see ya and stay safe.